Good morning. Thursday, August 8th, 2019, and it is 7:40 a.m. Good morning. So, thank you, Lord, for this day. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I'm going to get right into, I believe, Psalm 37. Fret not thyself because of evil doers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. He shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday. Rest in the Lord, and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any wise to do evil, for evildoers shall be cut off. But those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. For yet a little while, and the wicked shall not be. Yea, thou shalt diligently consider his place, and it shall not be. But the meek shall inherit the earth, and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. The wicked plotteth against the just, and gnasheth upon him with his teeth. The Lord shall laugh at him, for he seeth that his day is coming. The wicked have drawn out the sword, and have bent their bow to cast down the poor and needy, and to slay such as be of upright conversation. Their sword shall enter into their own heart, and their bows shall be broken. A little that a righteous man hath is better than the riches of many wicked. For the arms of the wicked shall be broken, but the Lord upholdeth the righteous. The Lord knoweth the days of the upright, and their inheritance shall be forever. This is going to be long, 40 verses, so I'm going to stop right there. That's right around 18, verse 18, so that's Psalm 37. Lord, we come to you right now in the name of Jesus. There was another horror show yesterday with the machete-wielding man up in Garden Grove who killed four people and hurt other people in his rampage. And so I don't know all the details on that. I just woke up this morning to it. I woke up actually in the middle of the night, or whenever it happened last night, a little after it was reported. So, Father, we come to you right now and lift up that man and pray that you'll help the police gather evidence against him for a strong prosecution. And that man, in my opinion, deserves the death penalty. But of course, we here in California have, I believe Governor Gavin Newsom has removed the death penalty. So, Lord, I lift it up to you. And, you know, now that we have the DNA, evidence of DNA, it's not so, I'm just saying, we don't want any ever again innocent man ever or woman to go to prison falsely accused. And so, but Lord, we lift up our neighborhoods to you. We lift up our precious loved ones. And we bind the devil in Jesus' name. The Bible says the devil roams about seeking whom he may devour. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, I have come to give you life, and life more abundant. So, if you don't know the Lord, you can go to newsandprayer.com, click on Sinner's Prayer in the middle of the website up towards the top, and click on that and say that prayer from your heart. Pray that prayer from your heart. Just talk to God with it. Or Google Sinner's Prayer and just pray the prayer of salvation. That way you're going to get God into your life, God into your heart, God's power into your life, and the power of God will be with you. He will be with you, and you will be able to pray better, okay? It's better if you have Him in your heart and life, and that way you'll have eternal life. Just, you know, confess your sinner, ask Him to forgive you, and confess, Jesus, you are Lord, okay? If you believe that, now, if you believe that in your heart, and I urge you to do that quickly, and sooner the better. But now, let's move on. We take authority over the devil from roaming about, seeking whom he may devour in the name of Jesus. We have power over the devil in the name of Jesus. All power in heaven and in earth has been given unto Jesus by the Father. When he died on the cross, he defeated the devil in spiritual reality. But God has a timing. You have to read the whole thing. Okay, read the Bible. Read the book of Revelations. There will be a time when the devil will be chained. Okay, he's a little g god who roams about. Jesus Christ defeated him on the cross. I don't understand it all, and you don't have to understand it all either. And so, but in reality, we have been given the name of Jesus, who all power and authority on earth, under earth, upon earth. Just use the name of Jesus, okay? Bind the devil. We bind you, Satan, in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind you from our lives, from our homes, cars, property, internet, in the spirit. We bind you from all bank accounts, from cyber attacks, in Jesus Christ's holy name, from our loved ones and our neighbors and friends and loved ones. Now, I go the length of going to the country, the states, the cities and towns, country and world, okay? Because God loves us all right? We're all equal in his sight, okay? We're all equal in God's sight, okay? And so I like to cover it all as much as possible. And that's where my faith is. But you, I encourage you to at least begin to pray over yourselves and your loved ones, your immediate loved ones, and your loved ones who live far away. Okay? God can answer a prayer for people on the other side of the ocean or the world. Okay? God is not bound by time or space. Okay? God is God. He made the universe, okay? And he has a son named Jesus who came and died for our sins. All the bad things we've ever done, do, and will do, God forbid, okay? So, he's given us his name, okay? To pray in that name, and it's powerful. If there were ever a situation, I would encourage you to just scream the name of Jesus, as he leads, of course, or hide. But the name of Jesus, just Jesus, 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 Jesus. However he leads you, use the name of Jesus, okay? And he will cover you. Now, Lord willing, he will cover you, okay? But I don't know. I think I've always believed that it's more powerful than even owning a gun. Okay, now I'm not opposed to the Second Amendment, okay, but I'm just saying, it's just like sickness and disease. You can, or all the money in the world, you can have all the money in the world and not know Jesus and not know how to pray, but you better learn how to pray, okay, and this is one thing I do in the morning and I do at night before I go to sleep. I do it in the middle of the night too, and I don't just pray for me, I pray for others. Okay, your loved ones, okay? We bind the spirit of fear, we bind the spirit of worry in Jesus' name. We bind the spirit of paranoia, suicide, PTSD, mental illness in Jesus' name, drug addiction, homelessness in Jesus' name. Thank you for Bill Pulte, Lord. Protect him as he goes out there and he gives money away. Protect him. We bind any harm coming to him as he goes out and gives money and blesses people with money just out of the kindness of his heart. We take authority over any harm to him and his family in Jesus' name, amen, or his team. We lift up our president to you and our officials in government and in the church, in Jewish, in Catholic and Protestant, in Jesus Christ's holy name. We lift up Muslims to you and pray it open their hearts to Jesus, Lord. And those that have, that are Muslims, that have come to Christ, we pray for their protection in Jesus Christ's holy name. Because you see, religious, man-made rules, and I'm not coming against anybody's religion, so stop being offended. But I encourage you to read the Bible. And I'm not going to make this too long, so I'm going to end it here. And I pray you would have a very good day, a blessed day, with peace. God send you peace and comfort, and comfort and peace to those who lost loved ones over the weekend and last night. And before that even, and people who have lost their homes in floods and tornadoes and hurricanes. Sickness and disease and poverty and lack, we come against it in the name of Jesus. Church, we need to pray, and you need to just realize, look, yes, Jesus can come at any time. But he said occupy until he comes, and that means get busy praying. Get busy praying, okay, for this world, and intercede and back the devil up and off of people, because they're helpless without God's help. They are literally helpless. People can be literally helpless without God's help. And that's why we need to pray and get the devil off. Bind a strong man. Bind him. You have authority over him. You, little old you, little young you. And you and me together, two or two or more agree on anything as touching anything, it shall be done by my Father in heaven. And he said, one will put 1,000 to flight, but two, just two, will put 10,000 to flight. So come in agreement with somebody right there in your home if you can, always if you can, and pray together. Bind the devil off your marriage, off your home, off your kids, off the schools, off the businesses, out of everything you can think of. There's never, never, ever, ever. You'll never run out of things to pray about, okay? And God says pray about everything. So sorry, I take that literally. I'm a prayer warrior, so you can be too, okay? And you know it, Christian, okay? But don't be praying evil prayers. Don't curse people. They're already out there in the devil's territory, if you know, if they are. So they need us to intercede and bind the devil. We bind you, Satan, off of gangs and drug traffickers and drug cartels and congressmen and women. Bind the devil off our president. He's not on him, I don't think. But if you know, if you don't like him, pray for him. The Bible says pray for him. And judge not that ye be not judged, you know? He said, he does say judge righteous judgment, though. When he does say, we can, as Christians, judge righteous judgment, okay? If we've weighed everything and we've done our research and we know we need to be praying for somebody that's, hey, or learn to do journalism, learn to start doing your own research and news, okay? And weigh one side to the other and find out, is this side really true? Or maybe I have to do a little more research, or maybe I'm just listening to the wrong hateful voices. Okay? Because our president is not a racist. Okay? He may have put things in wording that may not fit the narrative of political correctness, okay? But he's breaking down walls. Baltimore is going to get help if they'll let them help him. You know, Scott Pressler went over there with the team to clean up Baltimore, to help clean up some parts of Baltimore. I mean, you know, he can't clean the whole thing in one day. But he started something good. And guess what? I think it's the Baltimore Sun. There's an article. I have to read it. But it's like there's people over there that are fighting that. You know, that's political red tape bull crap, okay? And so we pray in those places, Lord, where there's that kind of stinky attitude towards the goodness of God and people trying to help. And then they're with their paranoia, they think they're doing it for, you know, no, we're just, you know, I'm sorry. We're not perfect. We don't think of everything, okay? We don't think to say, look, we're not doing this because we're doing it for political reasons, but then it would be interpreted like that. So I just lift it up to you. I'm wearing myself out here, and that's the devil's job, but I bind him in Jesus' name. The devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy, and to wear the saints out. That's what the Bible says. So he's not going to wear me out because I bind him in Jesus' name. And so I've gone enough. I'll end this now. God bless you. Have a good day. In Jesus Christ's holy name, amen.